Panama, you now have the floor on behalf of the Coalition for Rainforest Nations.
Thank you, Mr. Kosher. Panama has the honor to speak on behalf of the 52 countries of the Coalition for Rainforest Nations, of which the following have endorsed this statement: Bangladesh, Belize, Cameroon, Central African Republic, Chad, Cote d'Ivoire, Democratic Republic of Congo, Dominica, Dominican Republic, Fiji, Ghana, Guinea, Guyana, Honduras, Kenya, Liberia, Malawi, Mozambique, Nigeria, Papua New Guinea, Republic of Congo, Solomon Islands, Togo, and Uganda. Mr. Kosher, our coalition supports the statement made by the distinguished delegate from Bolivia on behalf of the group of G77 and China. We believe the 2015 agreement should be based on the elaboration of all six core elements identified in the decision 1CP17, mitigation, adaptation, finance, technology development and transfer, transparency of actions and support, and capacity building. On mitigation, the new agreement must take into account the latest scientific information with the global commitment to be set at the level that would maintain global temperature well below the increase of 1.5°C. While the agreement should be applicable to all principles of the conventions, must be respected, and leadership from the developed world countries must guide us in the reduction of global greenhouse gas emissions. The nature of nationality-determined contribution should be presented by all parties and should be differentiated. The 2015 agreement must be adequately informed by the work of other subsidiary bodies under the convention and build upon the important results achieved through the past COP decisions. REDD+ is therefore a central element of the 2015 agreement as defined by the Warsaw REDD framework. Adequate importance must be also given to the coastal marine ecosystem and their potential rolling adaptation and mitigation. Mr. Kosher, full support from a broad variety of financing sources, primarily from developed country parties, must be identified and allocated to REDD+ ASIM-ME activities. A new market-based mechanism, including REDD+, must be also included in the 2015 agreement. The mitigation potential of REDD must be fully taken into account and captured in the pre-2020 ambition track. REDD+ action should be quantified and duly recognized as a way to reduce emissions ambition gap before 2020. Our coalition sees four main objectives to be achieved here in Lima at the end of these 2 weeks: the inclusion of REDD+ and coastal marine ecosystem into the draft negotiation text based on the supporting decision of the Warsaw REDD framework; clarification of information to be submitted along with the INDCs early next year; a successful launch of the Warsaw REDD+ framework as per decision 10CP19, and anchoring in the new agreement; and the opening of the REDD window in the GCF. Mr. Kosher, in addition, as the co-president has emphasized, we need to accelerate the progress made in REDD+ by bridging the Warsaw REDD+ framework and the Green Climate Fund logic framework here in Lima. Finally, Mr. Kosher, we are looking forward to engaging with all parties in all these 2 weeks on the elaboration of the elements identified above. We are confident that you will assist us in the completion of this challenging work. Thank you very much, Chair.
Thank you very much, Panama, and I thank all groups of parties for their statements.